I'm Ty Comer, editor of Billboard.com, sitting in for Bill Wordy, and I'm pleased to be joined by Wes, Fred, John, and Sam of the fantastic Limp Bizkit. Thanks for joining us, guys.
Thanks for having us.
Howdy.
It's been about 7 years since we've heard from you guys. What took you so long? Where you been?
For a while, we were waiting on Wes. And now we've just we got back together a couple years ago, and we went and toured last summer to just get back on stage as soon as we could, and it was unbelievable. So we decided to go in and write a new album, and we've called it Gold Cobra.
I know that a lot of people are psyched to see Wes sitting here, and something that we didn't expect to happen for a long time. So how did you guys actually make amends and kiss and make up and get things back together?
Well, I didn't expect it either, and I think that that's the cool thing about life, is that if all your everything goes according to plan, you end up somewhere that is probably not where you should be. And I had to kind of fall off a cliff and fall down the cliff and hit my head on rocks and all kinds of different things to come to that, have that hit home. And through it all, there was never a point in which I felt the same chemistry and energy that I felt when I played with these guys. I think both of us just grew up a lot, and for me, I realized that a lot of my problems were self-created, and that I had to kind of come to terms with that, and it's a weird thing to realize that in a lot of ways you're being a prick and that you're the bad guy.
When it actually came down to writing songs and getting in the studio, did you immediately get your groove back, or did it sort of take some time to feel your way around and sort of remember where things left off, or how was that process?
That's why we went on tour first. We wanted to definitely do a tour first before going into the studio, because our live shows, whether you like our band or not, have always been where we shine, and people, even though they're like, I'm not really into Limp Bizkit, but God, your live show was great. And that's where we really feel the essence of what we do most strongly.
It seemed kind of effortless going into the studio and writing, because I think a lot of our evolution was we came into this staying true to ourselves and true to the music we make when the five of us get together. Through the years and through the success and through the monster being built and taking a life of its own, it's, there was always a quest for finding ourselves, for evolving, when really going through the evolution and evolving, we learn that what's most important is staying true to who we really are. So we went back in as Limp Bizkit, rap core band, and we didn't have any misguided thoughts of what direction we should go.
So talk about the content of the album. I mean, you've already have Why Try is on your website right now, and I know that it's getting a lot of hits, of getting a lot of listens to it.
It sounds like a Limp Bizkit record, but like, for instance, a lot of my friends that I've played it for have said, you know what, it sounds like you guys, but there's kind of a freshness to it too, and it sounds like the most creative stuff you guys have done. It sounds as different from our other records as they do from each other. It's its own thing, but it definitely sounds like a Limp Bizkit record, for sure. And you will definitely hate it if you hated the other ones.
Thanks for joining us. Good luck with everything. Gold Cobra is out summer 2010. Be sure to take a look for it. And be sure to check out Billboard.com and Fuse.tv for all your Nookie news.